Hi everyone, how are you all? Myself Nagappa, you are watching Appa Chemistry Classes. So now next our numerical chapter, numerical questions on atomic structure, which is very important. Definitely we may expect one questions from this atomic structure. So try to watch till the end of the video. So I am going to explain more number of questions with all the concepts. From the atomic structure, all the concept I am going to cover in this video. So each concept related one problem I am going to explain. You try to listen the complete video from starting to till the end, then you will understand all the concepts will be covered and related problems also. While explaining the problem itself only, I am going to explain you the related concept also. Then if they are asking in that model question, definitely you are going to do. Okay, so let's get into the video. The first question is, what are the first question they given? The number of nucleons in chlorine, 37 they are asking. What is mean by nucleons here? So it is the nucleus. Around this nucleus, these are the fixed path, these called what, energy cells. In the center of the atom contains protons and neutrons. The sum of the proton and neutron is said to be mass number. A is what here? It is a mass number. The mass number, how you will get the sum of protons plus neutrons. Now, what is the atomic number of atom? Here, atomic number is nothing but, atomic number is represented with Z. So, atomic number is represented with Z. It is equal to number of proton. It is equal to number of protons. Or we can define in another way also, atomic number is nothing but the number of electrons which are present in neutral atom. So that is number of electrons in neutral atom is also said to be atomic number. Number of protons are nothing but P. Now here what they are saying, the combination of this proton and neutron is said to be nucleons. It is said to be nucleons. Now you see, they given the water chlorine 37. Chlorine 37, whose mass number is how much? 37 they given. We know that chlorine atomic number is 17. So here what they are asking, nucleons. Nucleons means sum of protons and neutrons. The sum of protons and neutrons is said to be mass number. So here what is the mass number they given? Mass number is 37. Then number of nucleons will be 37. Is that clear? So from that neutrons will be what happens if you are taking A is equal to P plus N. No? So from this neutrons will be what happens, A minus P. If they are going to ask you number of neutrons present in the compound. Now you see in this case, here question number 3. The number of neutrons in dipositive zinc ion. I will explain question number 2. The number of neutrons present in dipositive ion of zinc. This is a zinc. Which is what they are saying, dipositive, means 2 electron it has lost. Okay, now so whose atomic number is 30, whose mass number is how much they given, 65. Mass number is 65. Then what they are asking, number of neutrons. We know that mass number A is equal to number of protons plus neutrons. Now protons is nothing but what? Number of proton is nothing but atomic number. Mass number is how much? 65. So, number of protons will be 30. Is there any change by loss of 2 electrons? There is no change in number of protons because the protons are present in the center of the atom. So, nucleons will not be lost, okay, by gain of energy or by loss of energy. So, electrons only will excite and de-excite from the atom from one energy level to another energy level. That atom may be lose the electrons or it may gain the electron based on the nature of the atom. Generally, metals will lose the electron, non-metals will gain the electron. Okay. So, plus neutron. That is, N is equal to how much it will be? 35. Number of neutrons will be how many? In the dipositive ion of zinc ion, dipositive, the given means, it is only there is a change in number of electron. Here, number of electrons will be how many? 30 minus 2, plus 2 means it has lost the 2 electrons. That is 30 minus 2 means 28 electrons. 30 protons, neutrons will be 35. Is that clear? No. Next one. Question number 3, question number 2 you see once. What they are saying? Question number 2. The energy of a photon is the given 3 into 10 power 12 x. What is its wavelength in nanometers? What they are asking? They are asking to calculate the wavelength, and they are given h value and c value. If they are asking to calculate the wavelength, when they are given the energy, we know that energy is directly proportional to frequency. From this, energy is equal to h nu. From that, we know that frequency is equal to c by lambda. So, E is equal to hc by lambda. So, then we know all the values. Wavelength we know. Wavelength we need to calculate. Energy we know. H we know. C we know. Just you substitute. Then wavelength is equal to h into c by energy. H 10 power minus 12 x. Then what happens here? In this case, h value will be how much here? H is 6.62 into 10 power minus 27. Into c value will be 3 into 10 power 10 by whole by 3 into 10 power minus 12. So now you see here 10 power minus 12, 10 power minus 27. It becomes 10 power minus 15 into 10 power 10. That is nothing but what? 10 power 5 it will be, minus 5 it will be. That is 6.62 into 10 power minus 5. We can write it as 662 into 10 power minus 7, it is what? Centimeters. Okay, now. So, 10 power minus 7 is centimeter is nothing but 1 nanometer. That is 662 nanometers. How many nanometers? 662 nanometer. Is that clear? Yes, question number 4. Now, what they given in question number 4? A light of source of wavelength lambda illuminates a metal and ejects a photoelectron with kinetic energy 1 electron volts. Another light of source of wavelength lambda by 3 ejects photoelectron from same metal with kinetic energy is what? 4 electron volt. Then what they are asking to calculate? Work function of that metal electrode they are asking. Work function is nothing but what? Threshold energy. It is also called threshold energy of the metal. Generally different metals will have the different threshold energy. Now you see here, this is a metal surface. When it is striked with some frequency containing light waves or wavelength containing some light wave, so electrons will be ejected. The phenomena of ejection of electron from the clean metal surface when suitable frequency containing light rays are fallen on the metal surface is called what? A photoelectric effect. Now you see in this case, whenever the energy of light is what? E. So, then what happens? Whenever it is fallen on the metal surface, electrons are ejected. They possess some kinetic energy. Okay. So, they possess some kinetic energy. So, if that metal want to eject the electron, that metal should possess the threshold energy. Means the minimum amount of energy of light which is needed to eject the electron. Okay now. So, that is what we are calling threshold energy, or it is also called work function. W. It is also called work function. Now here, threshold energy means, I think so you have understood. Threshold energy will be different for different metal atoms. Okay now. So for same metal atom, the threshold energy will be same. Now you see here, in this case, what they are saying? In the first statement, they are saying that a metal source of wavelength lambda. So first you convert this E into in terms of hc by lambda. Here hc by lambda. Here hc by lambda, not here. H and c are constant plus kinetic energy. Now here, they given the what wavelength they had taken the lambda. Now kinetic energy is how much they released by passing that lambda kinetic energy? 1 electron volts. Now just you take it as threshold frequency. Just you take it as it is a threshold frequency, threshold energy. Now here hc by lambda is equal to kinetic energy. That is hc by lambda is equal to W plus 1. Kinetic energy is how much? 1. It is first one. Now next one is what they are saying in the next statement. Same. That metal surface, when it is irradiated with lambda by 3 of wavelength of photoelectron from the same metal, their kinetic energy will be what? 4 electron volts. That is hc by lambda by 3 is equal to work function plus kinetic energy is how much they are saying? 4 electron volts. Now from this what happens? So 3 hc by lambda is equal to
lambda work function plus 4. Work function plus 4. Now from this we have hc by lambda is how much? W plus 1, that is work function plus 1 is equal to W plus 4. Then what happened? 3W plus 3 is equal to W plus 4. So W will bring this side, 2W it becomes. So this 3 you take that side, 4 minus 3, that is 1. So W is equal to 1 by 2, that is 0.5 electron volts. Work function of that metal will be how much? 0.5. Is that clear? So next question. Question number 5. Assume that 2 into 10 power minus 17 joules of light energy is needed by the interior of the human eye to see an object. The number of photons of yellow light with lambda is equal to 595.2 nanometers are needed to generate this minimum energy. Okay, how many photons of light which is having the this much wavelength? Okay, now one light is there whose wavelength is 595.2 nanometer, which generates how much amount of energy? 2 into 10 power minus 17 joules of energy. To generate that minimum amount of energy, it is very minimum, no? 2 into 10 power minus 17. So that to generate that minimum energy, how many photons are needed? They are asking. So we know that what E is equal to hc by lambda to generate for one photon. For one photon of light, energy will be, is equal to hc by lambda. According to Planck's quantum theory, the energy of a vibrating particle will be emitted in the form of small packets. That small packets of energy is called what? Quantums. Okay, now? Now here energy is equal to nhc by lambda for unknown number of photons. For n photons. Energy will be always, it is quantized. It is a fixed one. The fixed energy is emitted in the form of small packets. Now you see here energy is how much they given? 2 into 10 power minus 17. Is equal to n into h value we know 6.62 into 10 power it is in joules, no? So we have to take h is also in joule second, that is 10 power minus 34 joule second. Okay, so into velocity also should be taken in meter per second. All will be taken in SI units only. 3 into 10 power 8 meter per second by wavelength is how much they given? 595.2 nanometer. 1 nanometer is equal to how many meters? 10 power minus 9 meters. Okay. So that you multiply here into 10 power minus 9. So you do this calculation, then what happens? You are going to get the n value will be approximately 60. You do this calculation, you will get n value is how much? 60. Now simply you see here 10 power minus 9. Minus 34 is cancelled. Then how much it will be left over here? Minus 25 it is. Minus 25. Minus 25 plus 8 means how much it is? Minus 25 plus 8. That is nothing but minus 17. Minus 17, minus 17 get cancelled. Now what is left over here? 6.62 into 3 by 595.2 here. It is 2, no? You cancel it 3. So 3 times, 3.3 times. So 3.3 into 3 means how much it will be? 3 is a 9 and 3 is a 9. 9.9. Okay, now by 595.2. So and into 10 power 8 will be there. 10 power 8 is also cancelled. So you do that one, 3.3 by 595.2, you will get the approximately how many number of photons you are going to get? 60 number of protons you are going to get. So n is equal to, here 1 is equal to n into 9.9 by 595.2 it will be approximately. So n is equal to 595.2 by 9.9. That is nothing but 9.9 is nothing but 10. That is 59.52 you will get. Approximately it is taken as 60. So that is nearly, I am taking the rough calculation. Then you will get the what? How many number of photons? 60. Yeah, next question is 6th one. The radius of 10th orbit, Bohr orbit of the hydrogen is, they are saying. What is the radius of nth orbit here? Radius of nth orbit, the electron which is revolving in the nth orbit will be what? 0.529 into n square by z angstroms, in terms of angstroms it is. That is the formula to calculate the electron which is revolving in the nth orbit. Now here z is what atomic number, n is in which orbit it is revolving. Now what they are saying, radius of 10th Bohr orbit of hydrogen atom. For hydrogen atom z is equal to 1, z is equal to 1, n is equal to what they are saying, 10th orbit they are saying. Then radius of 10th orbit will be 0.529 is taken as 5329, that is 53 round figure. So into 10 square is how much here? By 1. That is 10 square is nothing but what? 100. 100 into 53 means it is 53 angstroms. So radius of 10th orbit will be how much here? The electron which is revolving in 10th Bohr orbit of hydrogen atom will be 53. Now next one, question number 7, similar model, which is very important one for mains point of view. Radius of n plus 1 minus radius of n minus 1 is equal to 2rn, where r n is comma r n minus 1 r n plus 1 are the Bohr's radius of hydrogen atom. That is, in nth orbit, n minus 1th orbit, n plus 1th orbit shall respectively, then calculate the n value they are saying. For hydrogen atom they are saying, no, for hydrogen atom z is equal to 1. Then what happens, radius of nth orbit will be, so radius is directly proportional to n square, is it or not? Now you see here, it is a constant, z is also 1 for hydrogen atom. Then radius of nth orbit will be directly proportional to n square. So that from this you can substitute here, radius of here nth orbit n square, radius of n plus 1 orbit will be what? It is an n plus 1th orbit. So then it is, in case of here what they given, radius of n plus 1 minus radius of n minus 1 is equal to 2 times the radius of nth orbit. Now radius of n plus 1 is nothing but n plus 1 whole square, minus radius of n minus 1 is nothing but n minus 1 whole square, is equal to radius of nth orbit will be, it is equal to n square. By solving this you will get the n value. Now here what happens, n square plus 1 square plus 2n, okay, now a plus b whole square, a square plus b square plus 2ab, minus n square plus 1 minus 2n is equal to 2n square. Now you see here, minus n square plus n square get cancelled, plus 2n and plus 2n, that is 4n, okay na, plus 2n, minus into minus it becomes plus, it is plus 1 now, it is minus 1, this is also get cancelled, 4n is equal to 2n square, n get cancelled. So then what happens, 4 is equal to 2n, then what happens, n is equal to 4/2, that is 2. What is the n value there? 2. Is that clear? 8th question. Now the radius of first Bohr orbit for hydrogen atom is 0.53 angstrom. The radius of third Bohr orbit would be how much they are saying? For hydrogen atom they are saying, first Bohr orbit is what? It is 0.53 angstroms they are saying. For radius of third Bohr orbit, radius of third Bohr orbit will be what happened, 0.53 into 3 square by z is what? 1. Okay, now then 0.53 into 9 it will be. 9 3 is a, how much it is? 9 3 is a 27, 2, 9 5 is a 45 plus 2, 47, that is 47 after 2 digits, 4.77 angstroms, easy one. So that is about complete about radius of orbit, radius of Bohr's orbit we had seen. Now next we are going to see the question number 9 here. So the maximum number of electron that can be theoretically present in the 7th orbit they are saying. Now you see here, maximum number of electron theoretically present in which orbit they are saying? 7th orbit. That is, n is equal to 7th energy cell it is. So the maximum number of electrons present in an orbit or energy cell will give you which formula? 2n square. orbit or energy cell, that is 2n square, that is 2 into 7 square. 7 square is 49, 49 2s are 98 it will be. Okay, now the theoretically it will be how many electrons are present in the 7th energy cell? Total of 98 electrons. Question number 10. Now when an electron is transmitted from 2e energy state to e energy level, the wavelength of resultant photon produced is lambda 1. So whenever the electron is de-excited from 2e to e, then its wavelength is how much? Lambda 1. If electron transition involves 4 by 3 e to e level, the wavelength of resultant photon is lambda 2. Then the correct relation between lambda 1 and lambda 2 is what they given? Lambda 1 is equal to x into lambda 2. Then what they are asking to find? X value is how much they are saying. Now we know that what energy transition E2 minus E1 is equal to h nu. Is it or not? That is delta E, the change in energy is equal to E2 minus E1 is equal to h nu according to Bohr's postulate. When an electron is jumping from higher energy state to lower energy state, it emits the energy. When electron is jumping from lower energy state to higher energy state, it absorbs the energy. That emission or absorption of energy will be fixed one, it is quantized one. That is, it is in packets of 1 h nu, 2 h nu, 3 h nu, like that. So here E2. Now here the electron is transition from 2E to E, that is 2E to E. E2 is E, 2E, E, and H nu can be written as Hc by lambda. Now, in this case, H and C are constant. Here, the wavelength emitted will be how much here? Lambda 1. Okay, now, so from this 2E minus E is nothing but E is equal to Hc by lambda 1. Just you keep it aside. Now, second electron, another transition involves 4 by 3, 4 by 3 E minus E. And how much wavelength it is resulting? Lambda 2, that is Hc by lambda 2. So from this 4e minus e by 3, that is nothing but what? 3e minus 4e minus 3e by 3, that is e by 3 Hc by lambda 2. Now we know that what here? 1 by 3 into e is equal to Hc by lambda 2. Now here E is nothing but Hc by lambda 1, no? That is 1 by 3 into Hc by lambda 1. It is equal to Hc by lambda 2. Now you see in this case, this Hc, Hc get cancelled. Now 1 by 3 lambda 1 is equal to 1 by 2 lambda 2. That is nothing but, what happens here? 1 by 3 lambda 1 is equal to 1 by lambda 2 is there. Now from this lambda 1 is equal to what happens? Lambda 1 is equal to 3 lambda 1 is equal to lambda 2. 3 lambda 1 is equal to lambda 2. From that, lambda 1 is equal to 1 by 3 into lambda 2. Then 1 by 3 is nothing but 0.33 into lambda 2. That is x is equal to how much here? 0.33. They given the what? Lambda 1 is equal to x times of the lambda 2, no? So in place of x, what we are getting? 0.33. That is x value. Is that clear? Yeah, question number 11. What they are saying? The ratio of wave numbers of the limiting line of Lyman series to the limiting line of Balmer series in a hydrogen spectrum, they are saying. The ratio of wave numbers of the limiting line of Lyman series to the limiting line of Balmer series. Now, wave number, how you are going to calculate? Wave number is equal to R into Z square into 1 by N1 square minus 1 by N2 square. So this wave number is nothing but what? Reciprocal of wavelength. Okay, now here they have given the what? Ratio of wave number of the limiting line of Lyman series to the limiting line of Balmer series in hydrogen spectrum, they are saying. So Z is equal to what here? 1 for hydrogen atom. For hydrogen atom, Z is equal to 1. Okay, now what they given? Still here they given the, now, in this case, here, what we have to calculate? Limiting line, they are saying. Limiting line means what here? The electron is de-excited from N2 will be at infinite energy cell. If the electron is de-excited to lower energy cell, then it is said to be what? A limiting line, limiting spectral line we will get. Now in case of Lyman series is the, in Lyman series, N1 is equal to 1, N2 is equal to infinite. In case of Balmer series, N1 is equal to 2, N2 is also infinite. Limiting line, they said, no? They are asking the ratio of wave numbers of the limiting lines of Lyman and Balmer. So, it is wave number of Lyman series to the wave number of Balmer series. It is equal to RR get cancelled, Z is also get cancelled because R is same. Now, here you see in this case, in Lyman series, 1 by 1 square, that is 1 only, 1 minus 1 by infinite square, that is 0, infinite square, 1 by infinite is nothing but what? 0 into R by 1 by 2 square, that is Lyman, for Baumann series it is N1 is equal to 2, that is 4 minus 1 by infinite square, that is also 0, RR get cancelled. Now what is left over? 1 by 4 it is, that is nothing but 4. The ratio will be what? Lyman to Balmer series, wave number ratio of Lyman to Balmer series will be how much? 4. Hydrogen spectrum, that is ratio they are asked, that is 4 we got. Now question number 12, you see here, calculate the number of waves made by Bohr's electron in complete revolution in its third orbit of hydrogen atom. Now we know that what in an orbit, circumference of orbit will be what? 2 pi r. It is equal to n lambda. So here number of waves is equal to principal quantum number. Okay, now how you will get this formula here? Simply, we know that what angular momentum mvr is equal to nh by 2 pi. But we know that lambda is equal to h by mv, de Broglie wave equation. So from this, mv is equal to h by lambda. You substitute here, that is h by lambda into r is equal to nh by 2 pi. So from this what happens? N into lambda you multiply. N into lambda. H get cancelled. 2 pi r. So that is to revolve the one circulation. They are saying the word to calculate the number of waves made by a Bohr's electron in complete revolution. In a complete revolution they are saying. That is one circumference. It must be equal to what? To Bohr's orbit. That is 3 into wavelength. That is number of revolutions will be how many? How many waves it will be? Calculate the number of waves. That is 3 number of waves. It is equal to principal quantum number. Next, question number 13 you see. The number of electrons with m is equal to 0 in an atom with atomic number 33. The given atomic number is how much? 33. Now, and they are asking their m value is how much? Magnetic quantum number is 0. Then how many number of electrons are present with m is equal to 0? Now to identify that, first you need to write its electronic configuration. Now 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 4s2, okay, 3d10. After that, 30 electrons are completed, still 3 more, that is enters into 4p3. Now you see here, ME value will be 0. In case of only one orbital, it is 0 here. 2 electrons are there. Here also 0. Here also 0. In 2p, we have the what? 3 values. Minus 1, 0, plus 1. Here this orbital will have the what? 2 electrons. Similarly, s2, p also 2 electrons. Here also 2. Here also 2. With m is equal to 0. Because in d subcell, we have the what? 5 values for the magnetic quantum number. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now here with is 0, it is minus 2, minus 1, it is plus 1, it is plus 2. With 0, how many electrons are there in D subcell? 2 electrons. In P subcell, in P3, how many electrons are there with 0? So it is minus 1, 0, plus 1. Here 1 electron is there. Here 1 electron, in remaining all cases 2, 2. Now 2 plus 2, 4, 4 plus 2, 6, 6 plus 2, 8, 8 plus 2, 10, 10 plus 2, 12, 12 plus 2, 14, 14 plus 1, that is 15. Is that clear? So, that is next question number 14. What is when the limiting line in Balmer series has wavelength of how many nanometers? Limiting line in Balmer series has wavelength, they are asking. That is 1 by lambda is equal to of hydrogen atom, they are saying, no? Of Balmer series has the wavelength of hydrogen atom. That is Z is equal to 1. So, R into 1 by N1 square minus 1 by N2 square. For Balmer series, Balmer and a limiting line they said. That is N1 is equal to 2, N2 is infinite. Then what happens? 1 by lambda is equal to, here R value is how much? 1.09 into 10 power 5. Or else you can take it as 109677 centimeter inverse. You will get in terms of centimeter inverse it will be. If you convert into meters, this can be written as 1.09 into 10 power 7 meters it will be. Okay, now. So it will be centimeter inverse, no? Then it will be 10 power 7 meters. Now you see in this case 1 by lambda is equal to 1.09 into 10 power 7 by, here it is what, 1 by 2 square, that is 4 it will be, minus 0 it is, 1 by infinite square, that is 0. That you calculate, you will get the what, approximately 364.4 nanometers something you will get. Okay, now, so that is by doing the reciprocal of that value, the given value, you will get the what, lambda as 364.4 nanometers we are going to get. Next one is question number 15. For how many orbital the quantum numbers n is equal to 3? Question number 15, what they are saying? For how many orbitals the quantum numbers n is equal to 3, l is equal to 2, and a spin quantum number, that is magnetic quantum number value, is plus 2 are possible? How many orbitals are there with these quantum numbers, they are saying. So n is 3, you have to compare with nlx here. So n is 3 and l is equal to 2 means what is the l values here? 0, 1, 2, 3, no? So for s sub cell, p sub cell, d sub cell, f sub cell. Okay. So then what happens here? What is the, for l is equal to 2, what is the sub cell? D sub cell, 3d sub cell. In 3d sub cell, in d sub cell, how many d orbitals are there? Total of 5 d orbitals are there. It is plus 2, it is minus 2, minus 1, 0, plus 1, plus 2. Now, in this case, which are having with magnetic quantum number plus 2 will be, how many orbitals are there in 3D subcell? Only one orbital. Is that clear? Only one orbital with n is equal to 3, l is equal to 2, and magnetic quantum number is plus 2. Only one orbital is present. Next. Now, next question number 16, you see. The maximum number of electron that can have n is equal to 3 and a spin quantum number minus 1 by 2. The maximum number of electron that can have n is equal to 3 and a spin quantum number is how much they given? Minus 1 by 2. How many electrons they are saying? So you compare with NLX here. Okay, now NLX method. Now n is equal to 3. We don't know L value. So n is equal to 3 means, here what are the subcells which are present in third energy cell? We may have 3s and 3p and also 3d energy cells are there. 3d subcell. These three subcells are present in n is equal to 3. Now in s subcell only one orbital. In 3p subcell we have p. In p subcell we have 3 orbital. In d subcell we have total of 5 orbitals are there. Now you see in this case, each orbital, if one electron is accommodated, then its spin quantum number is minus 1 by 2. If two electrons means 0 it will be. With the spin quantum number minus 1 by 2, they are saying here 1, here 1, here 1. So total, how many electrons are possible? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 electrons are possible. Is that clear? With the spin quantum number minus 1 by 2 or plus 1 by 2. Only 9. Okay. Next one. Question number 17.
So when 4F level is completely filled with electron, then the next electron will enters into a subshell whose n plus l value is equal to how much they are saying. They are saying 4F level is completely filled. After that, in which energy cell, in which level the electron will enter, whose n plus l value they are asking. They are not asking in which subshell it will enter, 4F subshell or 5D, what subshell it will enter and whose n plus l value is how much they are saying. Now just I will write you here, I will give you the arrangement of that energy order of the different subcells I will give you. Here 1s, 2s, next 2p. Try to note down everyone this one, it is important. 1s, 2s, 2p, and after that 3s, after that 3p, after that 4s, after that 3d, after that 4p, after that we have to get the what, 5s. After that, now you see this is the correct order of energy order of different subset. What they are saying, 4f level is completely filled, this 4f is completely filled here. After that electron will enter into the next higher energy cell is which one, 5d orbital. So for this 5d orbital you compare with nlx method. So in place of n what we have, 5. In place of L, which one, which subcell is there? D subcell. For D subcell, L value is how much? Just now I told you, no? L value will be 2 here. Okay, now for D subcell, L is equal to what? 0, 1, 2, 3. S, P, D, F. So for D subcell, it is L value is 2. Then what they are asking? N plus L value. That is 5 plus 2 it is. How much it is? 7. Is that clear? That is 17th question. Now you can see these questions. Question number 18. The radius of the first Bohr orbit of hydrogen atom is 0.52 into 10 power minus 8 centimeter. The radius of the first orbit of helium ion is 0.26 into 10 power minus x meters. Then the value of x they are saying. Just to, we know that radius is equal to 0.529 into 10 power into n square by z angstrom cities. That angstrom you convert into meters, that is 10 power minus 10 meters it is, because they given the helium ion radius in terms of meters. So for that reason we have to take in terms of meters only. So you calculate the radius of helium, that is 0.529 into first orbit they said 1 square by helium atom, atomic number is 2 into 10 power minus 10 meters. That is equal to whatever the value they given, 0.26 into 10 power minus x meters they given. So both are equalized, then 10 power minus x will give you what? 10 power minus 10, that is x equal to 10. Now next one, next question you see there. How many spectral lines in the spectrum will be observed when electron return from 7th to 2nd shell? Now you see in this case, what happens here? When the electron is excited from 7th, when it is coming from return from 7th to 2nd energy cell, 7th to 2nd, or else it may be whenever it come to the 6th one, 6th to 2nd it may come. Whenever it come to 5th, 5th to 2nd. Or it may be from 4th to 2nd or 3rd to 2nd it will be possible. Here in the first time it will be 5 spectral line. If the electron is re-excited to 6, then 6 to 2 it may be, or 5 to 2, or it may be 4 to 2, or it may be 3 to 2. Here 4 will get. So in this case what happens? 5 to 3, 4 to 3, like that, 3 here, here 2. Or else if you not able to identify in that manner, you can identify by using this formula. It is number of spectral lines which are produced when electron is de-excited from higher energy state to lower energy state. But when electron is excited from lower to higher energy state, n into n minus 1 by 2, that is spectral lines. But whenever it is de-excited, n into n plus 1 by 2, that is 5 into 5 plus 1 by 2. So what is n here? N is nothing but n2 minus n1, that is 7 minus 2, 5. 5 into 5 plus 1 by 2, that is 15 you will get. Yeah, see the question number 20 here. The wavelength of H delta line of Balmer series of hydrogen atom is nearly how much they are saying. The wavelength they are asking. First, what is mean by H alpha, H beta, H gamma, we will see. When there is a difference in the energy cells will be 1, then it is called H alpha, N2 minus N1 is equal to 1, H alpha, N2 minus N1 is equal to 2, H beta,
n2 minus n1 is equal to 3, then it is called h gamma. Okay, now n2 minus n1 is equal to 4, then it is called h delta. Okay, so if they are asking h delta line, so n1 should be what here? In case of Balmer series, they are saying no, n1 is 2. So n2 minus n1 is equal to 4, we know, for delta series, for hydrogen delta. Then n2 will be what happens? So 6. N1 you substitute here, minus 2 will go that side, it becomes plus 6. Then they are asking to calculate wavelength. Wavelength is equal to r into 1 by n1 square minus 1 by n2 square. R value they given. So you do this calculation, you are going to get the wavelength in terms of angstroms. They given meter, so 10 power minus 10 meters will get, that you convert into angstroms. 4.4101 into 10 power minus 10 in terms of you will get. So that you convert into angstroms. Now, atomic mass of an element. Atomic mass of an element is 19. The second shell of its atom contains 7 electrons. The number of neutrons present in its nucleus is. Atomic mass they given. That is sum of proton plus neutron is how much they given? 19. So second cell contain K and L. K cell is the first shell. L cell is the second cell. Contains 7 electrons. Without filling K cell, the electron won't enter into L cell. So L cell contains 7 means K cell definitely will have the water 2. It is completely filled one. 2 plus 7 is how much it is? 9. So total number of electrons present in that will be what? 9. Number of electron is equal to number of proton in case of neutral atom. That is number of protons will be 9 here. Protons are 9. Mass number is 19. The number of neutrons can be calculated by using this formula. Then number of neutrons will get 10. Now next question. If the atomic number of an element is 36, the number of electrons in M shell is, they are asking. Atomic number they given, they are asking to find the, in M cell, how many electron. When they given like that, you need to write its electronic configuration. So first energy cell is called K cell, second energy cell L cell, M, N. Okay, now. So in L cell, 8 electrons are there. In M cell, how many electrons are there? 18. In N shell 8, they are asking this in this M shell. M shell is nothing but third energy cell. In third energy cell, number of electrons will be 18. Now, the number of electrons in the ground state of atom, whose atomic number is 24, with azimuthal quantum number is L is equal to 1. Azimuthal quantum number L is equal to 1 means which subcell it is? P subcell. For P subcell, L is equal to 1. So, you write the configuration of this 24. And you identify number of electron which are present in the P subcell. Here in P subcell 6 electron, here also 6 electron. Total will be how many? 12 electrons it is. Now next question number 24. If an electron in hydrogen atom has the energy of minus 78.4 kilocalorie per mole, the electron present in which orbit it is? They given the energy and they are asking to calculate you. In which orbit that electron is present. So energy of nth orbit will be what? Always it is energy of electron in an which is revolving in the around the nucleus in an Bohr's orbit. It is always negative because potential energy is two times the kinetic energy with the negative sign. Now you see here minus 1312 into z square by n square. Here energy is directly proportional to atomic number and inversely proportional to square of the n value. We can write it as n is z by n whole square it is. And the energy of electron in a hydrogen like species, it will be directly proportional to z by n whole square. Now hydrogen atom they said, so it is 1. So n square. So energy they given, just you equalize. In terms of kilocalorie, we have to take this formula. Minus 1312 into z square by n square. So from that n square is equal to 4, you will get n is equal to 2. By solving this n square, you will get 4, n is equal to 2. That's it about what the number of questions which I had covered. I think so, different model questions which I had covered. So if you really like this content, and it will be very helpful definitely in any competitive exam, atomic structure related question definitely you are going to get. So if you are perfect with this model question, definitely you are going to do the questions. Thank you. Have a nice day. Keep watching Appa Chemistry classes.